So what is the glycemic index? What does it measure? Why does it matter? And when does it actually not matter and it's quite unhelpful? Welcome to Shape Fix. I'm Andrew, I'm a nutritionist and a sportsman, and I'm going to talk about the glycemic index. I guess you guessed that. So the glycemic index is really just an index. It's a scale in numbers from 0 to 100 that gives you an idea of how quickly a particular type of food will boost your blood sugar. So a high number means you have a very quick response and your blood sugar gets boosted very quickly, and a low number is the opposite. When you boost your blood sugar very quickly, you also boost your insulin very quickly, and there's these big insulin spikes as it goes up and down, depending on what you're eating, that cause chaos with your metabolism and lead to obesity and diabetes and other metabolic issues. So it's quite a useful scale if you are trying to monitor your glucose intake. Now, I say glucose because blood sugar is glucose. When you measure blood sugar, you're measuring the glucose in your blood. There are other kinds of sugar in your food, and this we will talk about in a minute, can become an issue. So foods are given a number on the scale, and you can find this on the internet. You can find a chart of food types and see where they are on the glycemic index. And people who are monitoring their blood sugar or are pre-diabetic or type 2 diabetic are encouraged to shop carefully and buy food and eat food that's lower on the glycemic index. Unfortunately, what happens very often is that that becomes their sole fixation, and they are not necessarily aware of the broader picture and other issues that can complicate this. So if you look at the scores and you take a particular type of food, let's say a peach, and it has a number on the glycemic index, there are things that can change that number. That number doesn't necessarily apply to every peach that you buy, because it depends how ripe it is. The more ripe it is, the more sugar it has. With other foods, it depends whether you cook it or not, because when you cook it, you break down some of the bonds and you absorb the glucose more quickly than if you were eating it raw. There will be issues around how processed the food actually is, because more processed food, more refined food, generally you will absorb it more quickly. There are varieties. Your peach, it depends where it comes from and how it's been crossbred and whether it's juicier or not. And then, of course, there's your body's personal response to what you eat, because that varies as well. That varies with your genetics, and it also varies with the condition that you're in. If you're obese, if you're pre-diabetic, if you're insulin resistant, and your existing sugar levels before you start eating, that comes into it as well. But as a rough guide, the glycemic index is all we've got. It's better than nothing. So let's have a look at it and look at some of the examples, and then we'll look at some of the problems. So high on the glycemic scale, highest of all, 100, is pure glucose. That's obvious. You're not going to absorb glucose more quickly than if you eat pure glucose. That's going into your stomach and boom, it's going into your blood, and that will spike your blood sugar. So that's used as the reference and given the number 100. Nobody's eating pure glucose. I don't know where you're going to get that from, but that would be 100. So everything else is a bit less than 100. But the high glycemic index foods are things like white bread, which is very high. White rice is very high. Pasta is very high. And these make sense because they are pure starches and they've been refined. And starch is just glucose. That's what starch is. Starch is glucose. So there you go, very high on the scale. Also, refined breakfast cereals like cornflakes, very, very high on the glycemic index. Sort of in the middle area between 55 and 70, you find things like bananas. Obviously, there's sugar and there's glucose in bananas, but there's also fiber and there are other things. And that's another thing that affects how quickly your glucose is absorbed. It depends what you're eating it with. So if you have a lot of fiber, which is why unrefined food is better than refined food, because the refined food has had all the fiber stripped out. When you have fiber, the glucose is sort of packed in amongst the fiber and your body doesn't access it as quickly. So Remember, the glycemic index is not a measure of how much sugar is in the food. It's a measure of how quickly it absorbs into your blood. So you can slow it down by eating whole wheat bread rather than white bread, or you're eating things like bananas. And whole wheat bread is generally on the medium glycemic index, but again, it depends on the actual bread, because most bread, in fact, all bread, all wheat bread, whether it's whole wheat or not, it's still refined because you still had to make it with flour. So it's made with flour, and then it has some wheat grains or fragments of wheat grains added back into the mix at the end, enough to allow the food companies, according to the government regulations, to call it whole wheat bread. But it's not. It's bread made from flour. It's refined. Flour is refined wheat. That's what it is. They crush it up into powder and then make bread with it. But it's had some wheat added, so there is some fiber, so you won't absorb the glucose as quickly as white bread. So it gets to go sort of in the middle. And then the low end would be things like fully intact grains. So if you were eating a handful of wheat grains, that's whole wheat. And that would take a while for you to access the glucose, because you have to crush it all up first and dissolve all the fiber and the proteins and things. So that would be lower on the glycemic index, but it's still wheat. It still has the sugar in it. Remember, you still get the sugar. You just don't get it all in a big rush. Mushrooms are very low on the glycemic index because they hardly contain any sugar at all. But then there's a catch. Remember I said bananas were sort of medium glycemic index? So maybe you don't want to eat too many bananas because, and you want to find fruit that's lower on the glycemic index. Well, then you have to go to the really sweet, juicy ones. And that doesn't intuitively make sense. Why would fruit that is more sweet be lower on the glycemic index? And that's because the fruit has a lot of fructose in it, which is also sugar, and is very sweet. But we're not measuring fructose, we're measuring glucose on the glycemic index. So when you eat a very sugary, very sweet peach, we were talking about peaches earlier, you get some glucose from it, so you get a number on the glycemic index, but the fructose doesn't count. But the fructose is sugar, and it's very, very unhealthy sugar. It all goes to your liver, and your liver converts it to glucose, and then pushes it back into your blood. But that time delay for that process to happen makes it qualify lower on the glycemic index. So just be careful and just bear in mind that the glycemic index is about the timing of the release of the glucose into your blood. And if you have to process it first in your liver, it immediately gives it a lower count on the glycemic index, but it's still unhealthy and it's still potentially dangerous. And fructose in particular is dangerous, because if it goes to your liver and is processed and there is no capacity for your blood or your body to take more glucose, then your liver has no choice but to turn that into triglycerides, and you develop fatty liver disease, and then you end up pre-diabetic or diabetic with insulin resistance and other dramas. Now, that's not just from fruit, because you don't get that much from fruit unless you're really binging on the fruit. But there is a lot of fructose injected into processed foods by the food companies. A, because it's a cheap process, and B, because it's very effective and very sweet and makes the food very attractive and addictive. But thirdly, because it's fructose, they get to label their processed food with a lower glycemic index score, which encourages people to believe that it's healthier. It's being injected with fructose. So you're overloading your liver with fructose. And when you overload your liver with fructose, it is exactly the same metabolic effect as abusing alcohol. Okay, this is just biochemistry 101. It's science. Science is what it is. You don't have to like it. It doesn't have to fit with your beliefs from before and your ideology maybe about how wonderfully natural and healthy fruit is. Natural, healthy fruit is fine. We don't have natural fruit. We have genetically modified fruit with extra sugar and extra juice. And we have a lot of fructose in other foods. So we need to be very, very aware of that. Okay, so that's one problem with the glycemic index, is that it doesn't take into account other sugars. Here's a perfect example. What do you think is higher on the glycemic index? White bread or white sugar? Now, you would think white sugar. It just makes intuitive sense, but it's not. White sugar is actually medium on the glycemic index. How is that possible? That's possible because white sugar, or sucrose, is half glucose and half fructose. So when you absorb that, the glucose goes into your blood and gives you a spike of sugar, but the fructose doesn't. The fructose part of it goes to the liver, that process that I described just now. So when you eat white bread, it's all glucose. Bang! Up goes your blood sugar. High glycemic index. When you eat sugar, table sugar, white sugar, it's a medium spike. Makes people think that it's better off eating a bowl of white sugar than a bowl of pasta, because a bowl of pasta is higher on the glycemic index than a bowl of sugar. Quite obviously, eating a bowl of sugar is a very, very bad idea, and you will end up with diabetes, and you will be obese, and you will have insulin resistance, and you'll probably end up with heart disease and all sorts of inflammatory issues. So again, the index isn't all that useful in a lot of cases. We talked about the fruit. The sweet fruit is lower on the glycemic index than the not so sweet fruit like bananas, but again, that's because fructose is sweeter than glucose. So there are issues here. And then there's one more thing to bear in mind. The glycemic index tells you how quickly a particular food releases glucose into your body. It doesn't tell you anything about how much. So it does depend how much you eat. So if you have a tiny little piece of white bread, you will have some glucose going into your body quite quickly. But if you eat 20 bananas, which are medium on the index, that will be worse for you because you will get so much more sugar. So that is called glycemic load. So it's the glycemic index and how much of it you're actually taking. So bear that in mind as well. Glycemic load tells you another story. So there you go. The glycemic index is about the timing. It's about glucose. It measures the spikes in your blood sugar. If you are diabetic and you're taking medication, you have to be careful. So avoid things that are higher on the glycemic index. But more salient advice would be avoid things that have sugar in them altogether. Remember, type 2 diabetes can be reversed with nutrition. If you avoid sugar and you cut down on your carbohydrates, then you have less need for insulin and you will start burning your body fat. You will burn the fat that's around your organs and your body will recover. And type 2 diabetes is absolutely reversible. It's not reversible with medication. Medication is a treatment and will stop you. It will keep you alive because type 2 diabetes is fatal if it's not addressed. But rather than just treating it so that you can manage to live longer in a terrible state, obese, unfit, unhealthy, constantly spending money on medication, you need to try and address your lifestyle, your nutrition, and reverse the diabetes, and ultimately you won't need the medication at all. So the glycemic index will give you some idea of what you're eating, but it's definitely not the whole story. Thank you for watching, thank you for sharing, thank you for subscribing, and any comments down below I will try and address. I can't always promise because I get a lot, but please, if you haven't watched the video, I know this happens, people will comment very quickly based on the title or the thumbnail, and it's obvious by some of the comments sometimes that some people haven't actually watched it. If there's anything you don't understand or I misspeak, please check the video notes, because the video notes, I try to produce notes that are quite comprehensive and actually follows a more logical thread possibly than when I'm sitting here talking about it. Okay, thank you again for your time.